In the world of film and television, we have to remember that not everything is what it seems. Behind those fabricated smiles that Kim Soo-hyun shows on screen lies a past that is anything but happy. So far, Kim Soo-hyun has built himself a pretty respectable career, but when it comes to his childhood, not everything was perfect. In fact, his tragic past comes as a shock to most people because on screen, he's always portraying pretty cheerful characters. Most fans aren't aware of the fact that Soo-hyun was raised by a single mother as his father abandoned him and his mother when he was only a little kid. He's an only child, so he didn't have any siblings to rely on during that tough period. In an interview, his middle school teacher revealed that he was quite calm and timid. This might have been the result of his parents' split. Soo-hyun's father is Kim Chung-hoon, who was the lead singer of an 80s band called Seven Dolphins. In an interview, Chung-hoon talked about his popularity at that time. He said, "At that time, my popularity was far lower than that of Soo-hyun today, but after singing at a nightclub, I would run away in a hurry because of too many fans." To this day, he still mentions his son in interviews, but he wasn't present in Soo-hyun's childhood at all. His parents got a divorce because of the fact that Chung-hoon was having an affair. Reportedly, he had started a new family with the woman that he was having an affair with. Soo-hyun and his mother struggled quite a bit on their own, especially financially. The two lived together in a rented house. Soo-hyun once revealed that it was hard for him to gather enough money to take a mandatory exam at university. He also reflected a bit on the hard times he had during high school. In his freshman year, they were struggling a lot financially. He said that when things were looking up, he'd treat himself to tonkatsu rice that he'd buy in the cafeteria. When he was short on cash, he would go to the convenience store so he could at least buy a little bit of bread to eat. While struggling financially was already hard enough on him, he also had to deal with a health condition. In his third year of high school, Soo-hyun experienced a moment in which he randomly fainted. Of course, this had to be looked into, and he found that he has a congenital heart disease. Despite his personal struggles, Soo-hyun revealed that at that time, his biggest wish was to become successful enough to buy his mother a house and end their poverty. Luckily, he already made this wish a reality in 2012 when he moved from a rented apartment to a leased house with his mother. In an episode of TVN's Taxi, he said, "My mother was really happy. Later on, I hope I can buy a great house that my family can live in." While Soo-hyun and his mother were struggling, Chung-hoon continued his musical activities up until 2009 when he released a solo album titled Brother Is Coming. The strange thing about this release was that he did not have any promotions for the album. When the media tried to interview him about this, he declined to speak on the topic. In an interview a few years later, he finally revealed the reason behind his behavior at that time. He said, "When I released the album, it happened to be the critical period when Soo-hyun had just become a star." It's true that around that time, Soo-hyun had just stepped into the limelight and started building a career for himself. Chung-hoon stated that he did not want to affect his son's activities by promoting his own work, so he stopped all promotions. Near the end of this interview, he revealed that he had a wish to sing a song with Soo-hyun. Chung-hoon explained that he hoped this song can empower fathers and mothers all over the world.
This is quite an ironic statement coming from him.
Soo-hyun's agency, Key East, responded to the statement by saying that it is inconvenient for him to comment on the matter.
They assumed Chung-hoon's wish to perform with his son was a strategy to promote his album.
During the interview, Chung-hoon also claimed to be in contact with his son and said that the two talked through the phone. Key East commented on this and said that these are personal matters and they can't disclose information about it to the public. Not only did Chung-hoon try to use his son for publicity, he also kept a very big secret from him for a very long time. It turns out Soo-hyun has a half-sister, and just like the rest of the world, he found this out through media reports in 2015. His sister is Kim Doona, who made her singing debut in 2015. She trained for about 3 to 4 years before she debuted with the OST How Do I Live Without You. During the time of her debut, the topic of Soo-hyun's sister was trending. Various sources reported that his sister had debuted with an original soundtrack for the drama High Society. Reportedly, the news that the two were siblings was released precisely after the soundtrack itself was released. They are brother and sister, but according to High Society associates who spoke to TV Report, Soo-hyun chose not to name her to the public because of complex family problems. Allegedly, the siblings spent their childhood together and are very close to each other. This was a strange statement because Soo-hyun had never mentioned having a sister. Many netizens were outraged at the Korean media for bringing up the alleged complex family status of Soo-hyun in response to the reports. The public was also criticizing Doona for allegedly using her brother to gain more recognition and promote her OST. Many people were wondering whether Soo-hyun approved of this media coverage or that they just revealed the sensitive information without his consent. Netizens commented on the strange nature of these reports. reports. Someone said, Kim Soo-hyun told everyone since debut that he was an only child. He also spoke while receiving an award that he only had a dog who is his only sibling. And someone else commented, what's the reason for suddenly revealing their family situation? If he didn't mention it, there was a reason behind it. Why reveal this right after debut? She is using him. Due to all the commotion that Juna's debut caused, Soo-hyun was forced to release an official statement regarding the matter. This went through his agency, Key East, who reported it to TV Report on July 22nd in 2015. They said, it is true that Kim Juna is Kim Soo-hyun's half-sister, but we know that they never lived together. Key East continued by revealing that Soo-hyun wasn't aware of the fact that his half-sister was training to become a singer. Despite not knowing this, he cheered her on anyway. Juna also spoke up about all the commotion surrounding them in an episode of Produce 101. During the episode, she even teared up while she was speaking about her feelings regarding the reports that were being made. She said that she was so upset and that it was all a misunderstanding. What upset her the most was the fact that people were speaking ill of her parents. She stated that she was okay with the fact that people talked badly about her, but bringing up her parents crossed the line. Juna revealed that she's deeply hurt that people got to know her for being someone's sister instead of discovering her through her music. As a closing statement, she said, I really want to show everyone that I can make it alone without anyone's help. While Juna's revelation moved a lot of people, it's Soo-hyun who is still suffering from the decisions his father made. This was made clear in an interview he held after he was discharged from his mandatory military service. Even prior to his military service, the remnants of his past kept haunting him. Soo-hyun had to undergo an examination to see if he was fit enough to enlist because in the past, he had a heart surgery. He was assigned to public service duty but insisted on doing a re-examination and was eventually cleared for combat. He officially enlisted in October of 2017 and came back nearly 2 years later. He was greeted by tons of reporters and about 300 fans, which is heartwarming given the fact that he didn't have any visitors during the time he spent in the military. In the interview he gave after he was discharged, he let the public know that in order to really focus on his activities in the military, he didn't accept any visitors at all. He also hid this from the other soldiers there so that he wouldn't stand out or gain attention for his decision. Soo-hyun is known to be distant from his family members, with the exception of his mother. Despite his tragic past, Soo-hyun has made a great name for himself. Not only the fans, but also his seniors think that he's a genuine person. His co-star Jung Woon-pyo commented on their time together during the filming of Moon That Embraces the Sun. He revealed that Soo-hyun hugged him when they met and that the two had a blast on set together. The two kept in contact even after the filming was wrapped up. Although he does not have a lot of family surrounding him, it seems like everyone in the industry loves him. On top of that, his hard work truly paid off as he is one of the highest paid actors in South Korea. Moving forward, things are only looking up for Soo-hyun. That was all on Soo-hyun's heartbreaking past. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!